So this is Vijay Kumar and from Naresh Technologies, and today I am going to discuss about group by clause. So what is group by and what is the importance of group by and how group by is useful. So the purpose of group by is grouping the records, okay. So there are so many clauses in SQL, like one is where clause, which is used to filter data and order by, and used to sort and group by, used to grouping. So the purpose of group by clause is grouping the records. So then we can group the records based on some column or some expression. For example, I can group the records based on department member wise, or I can group the records based on job wise, I can group the records based on year of joining, I can group employee records based on department wise, or I can group the records based on job wise, or I can group the records based on year of joining. If you take sales data, I can group the records based on product category wise, I can group the records based on customers country wise, and I can group the records based on year wise, like this. Or if you want customers data, I want to group the records customer records based on gender wise. So whenever you want to group the records, then group by comes into the picture. So when you want to group the records, then group by comes into the picture, okay. Then question is, like, why you want to group the records, okay, why you want to group the records? So because, like, see this, this query calculates the select sum cell from EMP. And what is this query calculates? This query calculates the total salary paid to all the employees. This calculates the total salary from the whole table, okay. The total salary paid to all the employees, or it calculates the total salary from the whole table. But I do not want to calculate the total salary from the whole table, I want to calculate the total salary. So select sum cell from EMP, and what is this query is returning? The total salary paid to all the employees, that is the total salary from the whole table. Like if you say, so what is the total salary paid to all the employees is 32,225, okay. The total salary paid to all the employees is 32,225, but my requirement is not from the whole table, I want to calculate this total salary department wise. So like for example, I want to calculate this total salary department wise, means how much is spent to 10th department, how much is spent to 20th, how much is spent to 30th department, and how much is spent to 40th department. So I want to calculate the total salary for each department. So if you want to calculate this sum, max, average, count, particular field wise, then you need to group the records based on that field. So if you want to calculate these values department wise, first of all you need to group the records based on department wise, okay. Then so the best example is, for example, there is a box. That box contains 10 rupees coins, 5 rupees coins, and 2 rupees coins. That box contains 10 rupees, 5 rupees, and 2 rupees coins. So I want to count how many coins are there. We do not need to separate, so simply we can count the number of coins. But I want to count how many 10 rupees, how many 5 rupees, how many 2 rupees coins are there. Then first of all, what we need to do is, we need to separate it. So make 10 rupees coins one group, 5 rupees coins one group, 2 rupees coins one group. Then after grouping this, easily you can count how many 10 rupees coins, how many 5 rupees coins, how many 2 rupees coins are there. So this is called grouping, okay. Now so, and for example, so this is the total, like this is the table, employee table. So it is showing each and every employee name, salary, and the employee working for department. So the first employee working for 10, and second employee working for 20, and third employee working for 10, fourth employee is also working for 10, and 20, 30, like this. So it is employee details. Next, But what I want to calculate is, I want to calculate the department wise total salary. So how much is spent to 10th, how much is spent to 20, how much is spent to 30. Okay. So see this 10th department, there are 3 employees working for 10th department, and what is the total salary paid to 10th department is, so 5000 plus 6000 plus 3000, 14000. And how much is spent to 20th? 4000 plus 7000, 11000. And how much is spent to 30th? 3000. There is only one employee working for 30th department, so the total salary paid to 30th department is 3000. That means I want this output. I want to calculate department wise total salary. So then what we need to do is, to get this output, so we need to use this group by clause. What this group by clause is doing, actually what is this is called, this is called detailed data. What is this is called detailed data, because it is giving the details of employees, and this is called detailed data. And what is this is called, this is called summarized data. Okay. And so what is this is called, this is called detailed data, and what is this is called, this is called summarized data. And the summarized data is useful for analysis. Okay. So the table always contains detailed data. So if you want the details of employees, go to the table. If you want customer details, go to the customer table. You want student details, go to the student table. You want employee details, go to employee table. So table always gives details, but not details, I want summarized data. Then, so how to transform this detailed data to summarized data? With the help of this group by clause, I can transform detailed data to summarized data, and the summarized data is useful for analysis. Okay. So summarized data is useful for analysis. So for analysis, the data should be in summarized form. If the data is in detailed form, difficult to do the analysis. So if the data is in summarized form, then it is easy to do the analysis. So for analysis, we need to convert, or we need to transform detailed data to summarized data. This can be done with the help of what? Group by clause. Now, so let's see one example. So then, how to use this group by clause? What is the syntax? So select columns from table name, where condition, next group by, next having condition. Okay, the select columns, whatever the columns you want to select, from which table, where condition, group by, having. But where is not compulsory, where is optional, having is also optional, having is also not compulsory. So here this is the syntax for group by, so that's why group by is compulsory, and the remaining clauses are not compulsory, they are optional. So group by, after group by, what should be there is column name or expression. Either you can write column name or you can write expression. So you want to group the records based on which column? For example, if you want to group the records based on department wise, write department number. If you want to group the records based on job wise, write job. Let's see one example. For example, my requirement is, I want to calculate department wise total salaries. So this query returns the total salary from the whole table, but my requirement is, I want to calculate department wise total salary. So to calculate the department wise total salary, group the records based on department wise. So select the department number, sum cell from EMP, group by department number. Okay. Then, so grouping is based on what? Department. So 10th department becomes one group, 20th becomes one group, 30th becomes one group, and 40th becomes one group. From each group, it calculates total salary. Okay, let's execute this query. So you see this output here. So it is showing the total salary paid to each department. 10th department 7450, so 30th 9400, 20th 14000, 40th 1300. So what it is calculating is department wise total salaries, but it's not sorted. I want to sort this output. I want to sort this output based on department wise. So if you want to sort, then use, so order by department number. So which order ascending, even if you don't mention also no problem, because the default sort order is ascending. Otherwise, instead of writing the column name, so we can also mention column number, like order by 1, order by 1 ASC. Here 1 means first column, first column. So in this select, what the first column is department number, and the data sorted based on department wise. So which is displayed first? 10th department is displayed first, next 20, next 30, next 40. So if I say 2 year and it is sorted based on some salary wise. If I say 1 year, it is sorted based on department wise. If I say 2 year, it is sorted based on some salary wise. But I want to sort based on department wise. So that is why I am saying order by 1. So let us run this query and see the difference. Now it is see this here. 10th department is displayed first, next 20, next 30, next 40, it is sorted. So this is what like purpose of group by, okay. So what it is giving is summarized data. What is this is called? This is called summarized data, and it is useful for analysis. To which department spending more, to which department spending less. So for example, I want to calculate the same thing, summaries job wise. I want to calculate the summaries job wise. For example, job wise I want to calculate number of employees. So how many employees working as clerk, how many employees working as manager, how many employees working as salesman. I want to calculate job wise number of employees. Then if you say select count star from EMP, if you say select count star from EMP, what it calculates? It calculates number of employees from the whole table. So total number of employees in the organization, how many employees are working in the organization? 14 employees are working, but not from the whole organization. I want to calculate job wise number of employees. Then so first of all, what you need to do is, first of all you need to group the records based on job wise, then easily can calculate job wise number of employees. Then how to group the records based on job wise? To group the records based on job wise, then use grouping is based on job. So job wise, what do you want to calculate? Number of employees, count star as CNT, and grouping is based on job, say job, and order by 1. 1 means first column. What the first column is? Job is the first column, and sorting is based on first column, and grouping is based on job wise. When grouping based on job wise, clerk becomes one group, manager becomes one group, salesman becomes one group, analyst becomes one group. So for each job, it calculates how many employees, how many clerks, how many managers, how many salesmen. Let's execute this query and see the output. Then see this here. So here, after running this query and see the output, how many analysts? 2 analysts. How many clerks? 4. How many managers? 3. How many presidents? 1. How many sales? So what it is calculating is, it is calculating job wise number of employees. Okay, then so like we can group records based on department wise or job wise, etc. So whenever you want to calculate particular field wise, sum, max, min, average, count, then use group by. So if you go to EMP table, so EMP table contains employees height dates. So you go to, you go and see the employees EMP table. So the EMP table contains employees height date. For example, then see select star from EMP. Then so here this contains employees height date. So when employee joined 17th December, 20th Feb, 81, like this. So height dates, the date consists of day, month, year. But my requirement is, I want to calculate how many employees joined in each year, year wise number of employees. In 1980, how many employees joined? 81, how many employees joined? 82, how many employees joined? So I want to count the number of employees based on year of join. Then so then what you need to do is, you need to group the records based on year wise. Then so but here grouping is based on year wise. Then but height date contains not only year, height date contains day, month, year. So from the height date, how to get the year? So from the height date, how to get the year? To get the year from height date, we need to use toCat function. So I am using toCat height date, then yyy. So, from the height date, I am exacting what? Year part. Either you can use true care function or you can also use exact function. Using exact function also, you can exact the year part. Using true care also, you can exact year part. So, year wise, I want to count the number of employees. In the output also, I want to show the year. Then, true care, height date, next YYY as year and count the number of records, number of employees. So, I am executing this query. See this, here 1980, how many employees, 81, how many, 82, how many, 83, how many. So, what it is calculating is, it is calculating year wise number of employees. So, it is counting the number of employees, so based on year wise. So, this is what the group by clause is, the purpose of group by.